Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 24 of Java for Tester series, that is assigning byte, short, long, float, boolean and string values to the int declared type variables. So we are going to check what will happen when we assign a variable which is declared with an int data type with the different types of values, okay, like byte value range of integer value, short value range integer value, long value range integer value, float, boolean and string. Okay, I'm going to assign all these different types of data type values to this variable which is declared of int data type and show you what will happen in real time. Okay, so let's start with one after the another one, guys. Okay, that is, let's start with the byte. Okay, what will happen when you assign a variable which is declared of in data type with the value which is in the range of byte? Okay, as we already know, the byte, okay, byte data type is used for storing the integer values, right? As the integer values in the range of -128 to 127, okay, this is the range of the byte data type. So what will happen when I assign the value which is in the range of this -128 to 127 to this integer? Okay, let's see. Int a is equal to some 9, okay, or some 120, let's say 120. You see, nothing will happen. So you can assign the value which is in the range of byte to the variable of int data type without any problem. Okay, it will be assigned and it will be printed as it is. A. Let's run this code. You see, the value got printed. And also, now let's try with the next data type value range, that is short. So short has the integer values in the range of -32768 to 32767. Let's take this value and try to assign this with the variable of int data type. Observe that we can assign the integer value which is in the range of short, okay, short data type value range to the variable of int data type without any problems. Let's print this and see whether it will get printed or not. Okay, it's getting printed because the ranges of the byte, short are smaller than the range of the int data type. Okay, the range of this is like 8-bit size, whereas this is 16-bit, whereas integer is 32-bit size. So these ranges will obviously fall below the range of the int data type that is acceptable value. Okay, since there these numbers are smaller than the range of this int data type, we can assign the values of, okay, values in the range of byte or short to the variable of the int data type. Now let's move to the next one, that is assigning the long data type value to the int data type value, int data type variable. Okay, long data type value to the int data type variable. As we already know that the range of this long is very high, that is 64 bit size. Okay, bigger number, the biggest possible number, integer value that is possible in Java is this long data type value. Okay, so copy this highest one of this long possible value range and try to assign it to the variable a of int data type. Obviously you will get an error saying that this literal of type int is out of range. Okay, so this is still an integer. It's Java is treating this as an integer because until you say l here, until you type l here, this will not become long. Okay, now when you hover the mouse, the error will be updated saying that cannot convert from long to int. It's not possible. It is saying you cannot assign a, okay, assign a value of long type, long data value type to a variable of int data type. That is not possible. So guys, this is not possible. Okay, assigning the long data type value to the int data type variable is not possible. You'll get this compiler error when you try to do so. So there is one possibility, guys. Even though you are getting the compiler error, if you cast this particular, okay, if you cast this particular value, okay, to the int type, you can do that. Or you have to change this to long, then it will be accepted. Okay, if you change the data type to long, that will be accepted. Or if you want this data type to be int and you still want to assign this long data type value to this variable of int data type, then you have to typecast here. Okay, say int and say save and run this. Right click run as Java application. So you got something like -1. Okay, how we got this -1? Let me explain. So how this is happening, how we got this -1, we have to find it out, right? So this is a bigger value, guys. So what it will do here is, okay, this value will be iterated through this range. Okay, so from this number onwards, okay, whatever the number, extra number comes, so this will rotate here. Okay, what it will do here is this typecasting will, okay, convert this number into this integer range. This is int data type range, guys, that is 32 bit. Okay, it will convert this 64 bit range of value to the 32 bit range by rotating. For example, you got some value like if you got the value as 2147483, the same value 647, instead of 647, if you got 648, okay, instead of this 647, if you got this 648, let's copy this and put into this okay, and convert this and save this and run this code. Right click run as Java application. Okay, what you got, guys? The next number you got, okay, that is after this, if there is an extra number, that is 8, that is not possible in this int data type. Okay, this is 64 bit, this is 32 bit. So in order to convert the 64 bit to 32 bit, Java, what it will do is, instead of, okay, making it 64 bit, this number 1 will be added to this. Okay, the range will be like this. After this 647, other end is 2147483648. Okay, again, if I give here 9, okay, let's give some 9 here and save and run, you will understand what I am saying. 647, the next possible number has come. Okay, so if I add this to number 2 here, so instead of giving the number 2, you cannot add 2 plus 2 here, right? The positive number greater than this number is not possible. So what Java will do is, for conversion from the 64 bit to 32 bit, it will go to this side. Okay, after this, next number is this one, then after this, the next number is -2144836647 is the next number. Okay, like this, the value, if it keep on increasing, it will keep on increasing this number. Okay, 647646645, like that. Okay, so it will keep on rotating, guys. What I mean to say is, okay, it will keep on rotating in the 32 bit range. Okay, if the given number is more than the highest number possible, then it will go to the other side and then keep on decreasing the number like this. Okay, if you have this number more than 5, okay, the highest possible number, if you have a number which is more than 5 numbers than this highest possible number, so it will, one other side we have minus, right? It will be 1 2 3 4 5. So this number will be printed. Okay, instead of increasing the number, it will keep on rotating in the same integer data possible range. Okay, that's why, guys, as part of this rotating, when I gave this big number here, okay, it kept on rotating within the range of int data type, within the range of int data type, and as part of that, it got something like -1. Okay, as part of that rotating in this same, okay, integer data type range, it got -1. Okay, as a result. Hope you understood it, guys. So the next thing here is, what will happen when you assign a float value to the int data type variable? So to this int data type variable, if I assign a float data type value, so how to do that? 3.69, this is a decimal value, guys. Okay, how to make this a float data type value? You have to add small f or capital F, anything you can add, guys. Okay, up to you. Over the mouse, it says that type mismatch cannot convert from float to int. Okay, the only possible ways are, one of the ways, convert to float. Okay, change this data type to float is one of the way, and the other way is, you can typecast this float data type value to the int data type. That means this decimal value will be waived off along with this f, and the remaining integer value 3 will be assigned to this variable a, and will be printed. So typecasting will happen in this way. Right click, run as Java application. Save this and run as. 3 will be printed. Okay. Now the next one, that is what will happen when you assign a boolean value to a int data type variable. So for this, if I assign some boolean value like this, true. Okay, there is no way, guys. You cannot assign a boolean value to the int data type variable. It's not possible at all. Okay, it's asking you only possible solution is change it to boolean. Okay, boolean can be only assigned to the boolean, guys. Okay, you cannot assign the boolean data type value to the variable of int data type. That's not possible at all. And what? And the next last one is the string value. Okay, what will happen when you assign a string value? Let's say I want to assign a string value like ufox.com text into this variable a. Is it possible? The same thing, guys. You cannot convert this string to a variable of int data type. You cannot even typecast also. This is not convertible. Not at all possible. Okay, so you cannot do a typecasting, or it will not automatically convert. There's no other way. Okay, other than changing this data type value to string. Okay, to resolve this error. Fine. These are the things, guys. Okay, these are the details of what will happen when you assign different data type values like byte, short, long, float, boolean, string to the int data type variable. So that's it, guys. In the next video session, I'll explain what will happen when you assign out of range integer values to the byte, short, int, and long data types. Okay, so that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.